Hi guys, it's An Cheng here of TrafficBeast.com. Today I'm going to show you how to professionally install WordPress. The problems with a lot of WordPress installations is that they are not secure. A lot of people install WordPress using the default settings, which are a path for hackers to go into your blog and hack it. For example, using admin as your username. So the installation I'm going to show you is going to make your WordPress a lot more secure. Also, the plugins which you install onto your WordPress, some have known errors because they're not written very well, and of course, they could be hacked as well. This installation will show you how to disallow people to see your plugins, therefore, less likely of them to use the plugin to go inside your WordPress installation. Warning. This installation, which I'm going to show you, will not use cPanel's Fantastical Deluxe to install your WordPress. Even though this method of installing WordPress is very fast and simple, it is not a very secure way of installing. So, with that said, let's dive in. To install WordPress, we go to the URL wordpress.org. Here, you can see the button Download WordPress 3.51. So depending on when you saw this video, the version could be a lot later, such as maybe WordPress 4.0. So we click here to download WordPress, and it's a zip file, so we'll save it. Here is the WordPress installation file which we installed. But right click on it and extract here. It will extract the software, which you can see will appear in this folder, WordPress. If we double click on WordPress, we're going to see all the files here, which we need to upload to our website. Here, I'm using the FileZillah FTP program to upload the WordPress files onto my web host. Now, I've got a domain here called mugsandcups.com, which is a testing domain I use. Here, normally, you would upload all your files to the root of your directory, which is public_HTML. So I would select all the installation files here, and then drag it across to upload the files to my domain, mugsandcups.com. Now, you don't have to install your blog onto the root of this domain. For example, if you want to install mugsandcups.com onto a directory called /blog, then you can go to that directory and upload your blog installation files here. And in addition, you can also install two or three more versions of your blog. All you need to do is to install them in different folders and directories. So you could have a blog installation in your root file under the folder public_HTML, and another version on /blog, and another version on /blog1, and so on. You can store as many blogs as you can in one domain. Now, while your files are uploaded to your website, what you can do now is to create your MySQL database and username in your web host's cPanel. If you don't use cPanel as for your web host, then find out from your website provider how to create your MySQL database. But remember, when you create your MySQL database and username, write down the username, the database name, and the password, because we will be using it later on. In cPanel, if we scroll down near the bottom, you will see here there's an icon called MySQL Databases. If we click on that, you should see here a place to enter your new database name. So for demonstration purposes, we can call this Mugs DB for database. Now remember, the whole database name is called ombiz_mugsdb. Now, depending on how you set up your your website, this name here is your username. It could be yours will be different to mine. In my case, it's called ombiz underscore. And then whatever I label the database. So now I will click on the button here, create database. And it will tell me that it successfully added the database ombiz underscore bugsdb. Now we'll click on go back. So now I've created the database. Next, what I need to do is scroll down and create the user. So this means that this username will be used to access that particular database. So I will call this mugs user. So it's very easy to remember. Then I will type in the password. So I'll type in my secret password here. I enter it once, then I need to enter the same password again. After that, I'll click on create user. Now, when you've created your username and your database, what you can do now is to select the user. Remember, I called it mugs user. Then the database, which I called mugsdb. So if I go down here, select mugsdb. Double check if it's the right username and right database, then I'll click on add. Now it will show me a database with all the privileges I needed to add. Forget all these, just ignore them, and select all privileges. After that, click on the button, make changes. Okay, then we're done. Your next step is to go to your blog's installation folder where you downloaded WordPress. Now select this file, wp-config-sample.php. This file is very, very important. It contains the configuration for your blog. At the moment, it can't be used because it has the word sample on it. So what you can do is rename it and remove the word sample. So if I right click on the file name, then select rename. Now just remove the word sample hyphen. That's it. It is now called wp-config.php. Next, we need to edit it. And normally I would open it using Notepad. Now here's my wp-config file. With this wp-config file, scroll down and you will see this part here. Your database name for WordPress, your username for WordPress, and your password. This is why I said you need to make sure that you remember what the database and username you created using your cPanel. So last time we created, if I can remember, it was ombiz underscore mugs, and the database was the database was db. Now for the username here, the name I gave it was ombiz underscore mugs user. Next, you need to type in your password here. So you type in whatever you typed in for your password. For example, 123123. After that, you scroll down to here where you need to paste in this security key. WordPress calls this a security key service. So you need to change all of this with your new security key. Now, so how do you get a security key? It's very, very simple. Here is the URL which WordPress has given you. Starts with HTTPS and ends with /salt. So we highlight this URL and copy it. So I go to a browser. Then I'll paste the URL which I selected before, press enter. This is it. This is the security key, which is unique every time you refresh it. So if I press enter to refresh this, you can see everything here has changed. So if I click on the refresh reload button again, every time I do it, the security key changes. What you need to do is select what you see on the screen here. Once you've selected that, right click and click on copy. Now we go back to our wp-config file here. So we highlight all of this, then we click on the delete key, then we'll right click and paste the security key which we got. After that, if we scroll down here, you can see this part here, table prefix WP. Now all the databases created in WordPress have the prefix WP underscore. As I mentioned before earlier on in this video, hackers know about this, therefore it makes it much easier for them to target your WordPress databases. Therefore, what we can do is to change this prefix, even adding a number such as 58 and even A will make it virtually impossible for anyone to guess what your database's prefixes are. So if we add this WP58, click on File, Save, that's it. Our WP config file is now finished. Now comes the fun part, actually installing your WordPress blog. Now if you go to your domain, in my case it's Mugs and Cups, and click on enter. Now remember, if you installed it on the folder blog, you would go here. If it's called blog 1 or if you call it testing 1, 2, 3, depending on where you installed your blog, just go to that directory or folder and press enter. So in my case, I installed it on the root, which is underscore public underscore HTML. And if I go to Mugs and Cups, it says here. There doesn't seem to be a wp-config file. That is because we changed the wp-config hyphen sample file into wp-config.php, but it can't find it because we haven't uploaded the new file yet to our website. So right, what we need to do now is go back to FileZilla. So here we are in FileZilla. Now, if we go here and find the file which we changed, wp-config. Now on our website over here, we're going to see that the file is still called hyphen sample. So we can just leave that there or delete it. So now, just for sakes, we delete it. Now, the wp-config file, we need to upload it to our server. Give it a few seconds. Okay, here it is. So right now, we go back to our website and refresh it. Okay, it recognized our wp-config.php file, so it's given us this installation screen. Now, it may seem a lot of work going through all that preparation, but let me assure you that it is necessary if you want to make your WordPress blog installation secure. The first setting which we need to enter is called the site title, which is basically the name of your blog. In my case, I would obviously call it Mugs and Cups. Now the next field is username. Default, it is called admin. You need to change this because malicious attacks or from hackers will target the username admin. So to throw them off guard and make it virtually impossible to hack into your blog, you can change your username to something like Mugs a mini. Now, no one is going to guess that your username is called Mugs Mini. And if you want to be very secure, you can add the number 2 onto it. But just make sure that you remember what your username is. Next, you need to enter in your password. For me, normally, I would enter in something which only I will know. But sometimes a very, very secure way of entering a password is to add numbers and also symbols, such as the hash key. Once you do that, it is virtually impossible for anyone to guess what your password is. There's a password mismatch here, so I'll type in the password again. Okay, that's my password. Next is my email, so that if I forget what my password is, I will need to reset it, and once I reset it, it will send me an email. So here I would enter in my email address. After that, if I go to the bottom, here, for privacy, I would allow the search engines to index this site. Of course, I will select yes, because I want my blog to be found by the search engines, unless this is a private blog, which I don't want anyone to know about. After all that is done, and you remember what your username and password is, you can click on Install WordPress. And that's it. Your WordPress has been installed. Here's our username, which we type in, and of course, the password. Here we are. You have now installed a secure WordPress blog. And that concludes today's training. If you like today's video, you can subscribe to my YouTube channel, where I will give you more tips and stuff on how to market online. And also have a special bonus for you, which is an awesome video on how to design your blog to maximize your profits, grow your list, and generate mass amounts of traffic. This is an excellent video, so just click on this button and get access to it. This is Alan Cheng of TrafficBeast.com. Thanks for watching.